Hey everybody, welcome back and thanks for watching. In this video, we are going to talk about this pistol that I have here. So this is my attempt to create a civilian version of the NGSW program, so the next generation squad weapon. Did I say that right? NGSW, next generation squad weapon that the military is implementing. Now they are using the Sig MX7 or M7, and that's chambered in the 6.8x51 or the 277 Fury. So the idea is I wanted a comparable firearm similar to that, but something that's a little bit easier for me as a civilian to actually implement. So what I did here is I went with the AR-10 platform. I'm using the Aero M5 lower receiver, and then I used some kind of just generic parts to just put it all together. So the upper receiver is kind of a no-name brand. I have the SB Tactical SBA4. I originally had the SBA5 on there, but that broke. So I switched that out. You can find my video in. I'll put a link to that debacle. Let's see. I went with the Deadshot barrel. So this is a 12-inch stainless steel heavy barrel from Deadshot, and it is chambered in 6.5 Creedmoor. So that's where a big difference comes in, where the 277 Fury, you can get that, but it's not all that readily available. It's harder to get, but the 6.5 Creedmoor definitely is easy to get. And then I topped it off here with the Dead Air key mount muzzle brake, and then I have ran it with the suppressor on there as well, the Dead Air Nomad 7.62 suppressor. And then I have the Vortex Strike Eagle. This is a 1:8 magnification, which is what the next generation squad weapon was utilizing as well. So the 1:8 magnification. Now they're using also a Vortex, but it is, I can't remember what they call it, but it's their next generation optic. And that has the rangefinder and the actual holdover reticle. So all that computer programming. So super high end, I'm not going to be able to get that. So I went with the Strike Eagle instead. Okay, now I want something comparable to what the military is going to be using. So something with a shorter barrel. Theirs is a 14.5. I went with a 12. I just like the shorter barrels in this configuration. We could go with the 14.5 if we wanted to. I just wanted to keep it as short as possible. But the concept is we want to be able to engage targets at a longer range. So is that possible with something like this in the 6.5 Creedmoor with the 12-inch barrel? So let's see if we can do it. All right, so now with the next generation squad weapon, you have a 1:8 optic, and we want to see how far we can actually push this. So we have it at 800 yards right now. So we're going to go all the way in. All right. Okay, send in this one. See where it hit? All right, I'm going to go again. Ready?
I'm a little low, about 4 feet low. A little high to the right, about 2 feet to the right. Almost, like right under it.
What?
I think you got it.
Oh, okay, cool. All right, so that's 800 yards that we are shooting at right now. with a 1-8 magnified scope. And it really, it doesn't feel that difficult to do. Okay, going again. That was high.
That was too high. That was like a 1 o'clock. So bring it down. Oh, almost about a foot or two on top of it.
All right. All right. So, yep, definitely doable with this 12.5 inch. Ooh. Well, yep, definitely doable with the 12.5 inch 6.5 Creedmoor. So, I don't know, I'm a little bit surprised at that. I wasn't thinking this was going to be an easy thing to do. And not because the caliber isn't capable of it, but mainly because I was worried more about the optic being capable of it, because it's only an 8 magnification. So it's really not giving us a whole lot to work with here. All right, so it is definitely capable of going out to 800 yards. Now, I'll admit that setup that I, well, so my shooting position was not the greatest. I was using the UTG overbore bipod, which I think is really good, but just being up on the back of my truck there really wasn't the most stable place for me to do that. So I wasn't shooting as well as I would have liked, but it was definitely doable even from that position. So I am thinking that this could be probably something that could go out to 1,000 yards. Now, how much energy is it going to keep at 1,000 yards? That I'm not sure. So we'll need to be doing a little bit more testing to see what we do there. Maybe we'll put a block of clay out there, see what kind of energy we get there at the tail end of 1,000 yards. But yeah, so I'm going to be taking this out again, and I'm going to be shooting from a prone position, a little bit more stable position, so I can just be a little bit more steady. And then I think the downside, well, not the downside, but the limiting factor is going to be the optic that I have on here. And then also, you know, their 1-8 Vortex, that to do the 1,000 at 800 yards, that was just kind of on the extreme end for this type of optic. So I'm probably going to put one on here. I'll probably put my Arkin on here. That goes to 24 to do the 1,000-yard shots, because I think that's really what's limiting this setup here. So I'll do that for the next video. Till next time, we'll see you later.